When you play with Legos, do you think about the parts of the Lego? Have you ever thought about what makes a Lego work? Well, there are really only two main parts of Legos. One of them is right here, and it's called a stud. The big Legos have lots of studs, and the smaller Legos have fewer. Like here's one with just three studs, one, two, three. The other part of the Lego brick is the tube, and it's on the underside, the hollow side, and it's a hollow tube that goes all the way in to the Lego brick, and the larger Lego bricks have more tubes. The smaller Lego bricks have fewer. Like here's a Lego brick with just one tube. So these two parts, the studs and the tubes, work together to allow you to snap the Lego bricks together. The studs fit in snugly between the tubes so that bricks will snap one to the other. That lets you do things like create really fantastic, complicated structures like this castle, or fantastic spaceships, or really anything you want, just because the Lego brick has those two simple parts, the stud and the tube. Well, I wonder if words that we say with our mouth have any parts to them, or are they just one big glob? When you say a word out loud, like when you say house, or hi, or bye, or ice cream, does that word have any parts, or is it just sort of one big glob? Let's see if we can figure out what the parts of spoken words are. I think we need to get some help from our friends here and see if we can look at the parts of spoken words. And to do that, I'm going to ask our friend Jack here, this is Jack, if he will say five vowel sounds. And then I'm going to ask Jill, this is Jill, if she will say five consonant sounds. I know you've probably heard the terms vowels and consonants. Vowels and consonants. Vowels, you may have heard, are A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y, and consonants are every other letter. But that's when you're talking about letters. We're not talking about letters right now. We're talking about the words that come out of our mouths. And so let's see, when we think about them as speech sounds, what vowels are and what consonants are. So first let Jack say five vowel sounds, and you observe it and actually imitate the vowels that he says. See what your mouth is doing when you make those vowels, and then we'll have Jill do the same with consonants and see if you can tell what your mouth is doing when it says vowels versus when it says consonants. So I'm going to actually draw Jack and Jill's mouth as they speak or when they finish speaking, so we can see if we can tell what the mouth is doing. Okay, Jack, say some vowels. You say them after him. Ah. Say ah. Say say e, say say eh. Okay, now it's Jill's turn. Jill, Say some consonants. Say them after her. Say Feel what your mouth is doing? Say b. Say s. T. Ch. Could you feel any difference between the vowels and the consonants and what your mouth was doing? Well, as Jack says a couple more of those vowels, let me see if I can draw his mouth. Say ah. Say Okay, so that's what his mouth seems to be doing when he's saying vowels. Now let's see if I can draw Jill's mouth when she says some consonants. Say Say b. D. S. Did you hear that when Jack said the vowels, his mouth was mostly open? And when Jill said the consonants, her mouth was, well, something in her mouth was closing. When she said and b and s and d. So it turns out that that is the difference between vowels and consonants. Vowels are open sounds. Well, your mouth is open when you're saying them, and actually you can yell a vowel. And it's loud. It can be very loud. But when you say a consonant like m or b or d or ch, you can't yell it because something's closing. So the difference between vowels and consonants is that vowels are open sounds. Your mouth is open when you say them. And consonants have something that's closing. So let's see if we can take these two parts of spoken words, vowels and consonants. There really aren't any other kinds of speech sounds humans make. This is it. It's either, speech sounds are either vowels or consonants. And use them to understand the way words are put together, so that we could maybe think about making words that are as cool and fantastic and intricately structured as those Lego castles we were looking at.